Nithyanandam. Hi, my name is Ma Nithyanandam Swami. I'm a disciple of His Holiness Paramahamsa Nithyananda Swami and a sannyasi in the Nithyananda Sampradaya. In today's video, I wanted to stress the utility value of having a guru in your life. And this is particularly important if you're a sannyasi or someone who's thinking about taking up sannyas. Because the whole central part of your life is the guru when you're on the path of sannyas. And why is this so awesome? Well, let's just take your life right now. Who is in control? Who is making the decisions? You, hopefully. Maybe you have input from family members. Maybe you listen to your friends. Maybe you learn things on the internet. Now, this is all well and good, but let's look at that a little bit deeper. Who you are today is based on what? All of your past experiences, all of your understandings you gained in life. And these understandings, if you look deeper, based upon a lot of wrong ideas, a lot of pressures, a lot of misconceptions about life, a lot of wrong cognitions about life, a lot of wrong ideas that are put on us by, whether it's family, whether it's society, whether it's a schooling system. We're basically a hodgepodge of all the things that happened before us. And we operate from that space. We operate from those patterns and those cognitions. And we think that we are living a life as we want it. But if that's the case, then we won't be still striving to achieve fulfillment. Or we won't be making the same mistakes. Or we won't be so distraught when we fail. Or we won't be having failed relationships or not understanding why a relationship isn't working out. Or not able to maybe achieve the grades or job that we want. I'm not saying everything in your life is necessarily not as you want. But definitely there are major parts that are not. And that's true for everyone. Because we're not given the education and understanding about how life actually works, how the cosmos works, how we connect to the cosmos, how we connect to the divine, and who we really are. And that's the operating system of the cosmos. But we're taught something so small and so misconceived, and then we are put out into this world and we don't make it the way we want to make it. Now, if you're saying, okay, I'm happy, I'm blissful all the time, then maybe this video and maybe enlightenment, the idea of it is not really what you're looking for. Fine. If you're truly in a blissful space all the time, then probably you don't need to watch this video. But what I found in my personal experiences, before I met Swamiji, yes, there are times when I was happy. Yes, I achieved some things in my life that I wanted to achieve. But somehow there was always a dip afterwards, or there was always a downfall, or it wasn't enough, or didn't quite achieve fully what I wanted to achieve, or the goal just kept changing and shifting. But then after meeting Swamiji, I understood there's a concept called Nithyananda. Nithyananda means what? It means eternal bliss. It's not just bliss, and it's not just eternal. It's always being blissful. That concept really, really resonated with me, and it felt right. And hopefully it feels right for you too. Because I felt very strongly at the time that, yes, we should always be happy. We should always be in that blissful state. So when you hear about it, it's a concept. But then when you see Swamiji function from that space, it just will change your life. Just observing, being around Swamiji, seeing how he is in all situations, you'll see the space of Nithyananda never changes, never is touched. He may put on different faces for the situation, but that blissful space is always there. His state is untouched. So now we have our life experiences. We have a concept that our life experiences would show us that we go up and down. Sad, happy, successful, failure, worry, accomplishment, everything. Then we know that there's a concept of eternal bliss, always being in that blissful state, come what may. And we have Swamiji who's radiating that, who's living it and giving us the science on how to be established in that space. So just like anything else in life, when you decide, I want that, I want to learn how to play flute, I want to learn how to play tennis, I want to be the best basketball player, or I want to learn how to be the best manager. You can do by trial and error, but you may take years, if not lifetimes, to make it. But usually, we have to go get help from a teacher, someone who is more accomplished, someone who is an expert in the field. And the field I'm talking about right now, is the field of life. An enlightened master, like Swamiji, has mastered this thing we call life. He knows the science, the whys, what the purpose of our life is, where we're at, where we've been. And from that context, he guides his disciples. And each guru-disciple relationship is unique, because each disciple is unique. Swamiji's teachings are the same, but he has to customize it to all the different minds that come to him. So if you see the wide scope of what is happening in your life, how much very little we actually know, but we're still driving a car which we don't get the user manual for. If you understand that makes no sense, then you'll also understand that it makes a lot of sense to have a guru. And that is exactly why the guru-disciple relationship is the foundation of Hindus. That's why it is so important to cultivate that relationship, take advantage of it, and benefit from it, from the beauty of it, and the utility value of it, of what it does for you, and how you, once you benefit, how you impact those around you. So if you have any doubts about having a guru or taking sannyas, because in the life of a sannyasi, you've decided that Swamiji knows what's best for me. Swamiji will guide me. Whatever he says, he knows me better than me. He knows what lies ahead. With that context, when you take the jump for sannyas, it'll be so easy. But having that context is your strength. And this is all the logical way to help those who are maybe more logical in their mind. But once you jump in, once you see, the whole journey is just such overflowing sweetness and compassion. Just one look from Swamiji, one word from Swamiji, just seeing how he takes care of you, how he takes care of all his disciples, never, never, ever gives up. Literally, I learned from Swamiji the concept of not giving up. And I'll speak on that in a different video. But really, there is no other relationship in one's life that's worthy of what a guru-disciple relationship can do. Because there's no two interests involved. His interest is only making you realize your full potential. In any other relationship, you're also catering to the needs of the other person. But here, even when it looks like you're achieving something Swamiji wants, at the end of the day, he only wants that because it will add something to you. I will remove something from you that's not required. So hopefully I've given more insight into why it's so important to have a guru, and why I'm so grateful to actually have a guru.